Hey everyone, I'm doing a video series about the Genie garage door openers that use rolling codes. I've written a Flipper Zero application that collects all 65,000 codes and automates the process for you. Once you have the codes, there's a variety of ways you can use them to open your garage door. In this first video, I'll show you the steps to clone your own Genie remote, then we'll look at a Python script to create a sub-gigahertz file for one of the codes you captured. You can then use the Flipper Zero to open the door, as demonstrated earlier. In future videos, we'll discuss more advanced techniques and technical details. Let's get started. The first thing I wanted to be clear about is we're just recording all of the signals away from the opener, and then playing back those signals in the order we care about. We don't discover the manufacturer's code or other protections that are in place, so this technique only works if the receiver is paired to the remote. Many people use their Flipper Zero as a universal remote, and that's the intended audience for this video. I've published my keys.txt file so that you can sync your receiver to those keys, but then anyone who owns a Flipper and downloads this text file will be able to open your garage. If you're going to use my keys, please be sure you understand the process for removing all paired remotes so you can remove access when you're done with your testing. In Visual Studio Code, we're going to press Ctrl+Shift+P and then we're going to type get clone and click on that option. Next, we'll put in the URL for the Flipper Zero tutorials. And then in folder, we'll choose a folder to save our files. And then we'll go ahead and click cancel. And then we'll expand Flipper Zero tutorials, sub gigahertz, apps, right click on Genie Recorder and say reveal in file explorer. Then in VS Code, Ctrl+Shift+P. And this time we'll do get clone recursive. And then this time we're gonna use the URL for the firmware. And then we'll pick a folder to store the firmware. And then this process will take a bit while it recursively clones the firmware. So I'm going to go ahead and speed up the video. And this time we will choose open. We'll expand the application's user folder. Then we'll bring up File Explorer from before and drag Genie Recorder into application's user. Next, we'll right-click on FBT and choose Open an Integrated Terminal. And then we'll run FBT VS Code underscore dist. This will download the toolchain and populate our .vs code folder. With that complete, we'll do Ctrl+Shift+B and then choose Debug Build Firmware. This step can take a while, so I'll speed up the video as well. Once it's complete, we'll go into Firmware, Targets, F7, and open API Symbols CSV, and then we'll search for Storage File Sync. Make sure it says Storage File Sync, and then change the minus to a plus. This allows our application to call this API. Go ahead and save the file, and then we'll go into lib, sub gigahertz, protocols, and then open the keylock.c file. The Genie remote needs speeds of 200, 400, and 70 for the short, long, and delta. Save this file, then Ctrl+Shift+B and choose debug flash USB with resources. Make sure your Flipper's plugged in and that QFlipper's not running. This can take a while, so I'll go ahead and speed up this part of the video. If everything worked correctly, you should see firmware update success. Next, we'll open sub gigahertz and then go into read and then press the left button to go into config and change the frequency to 315 megahertz. Then we'll click the back button to start reading, And then on our remote, we're going to go ahead and press a button on our Genie remote. So we were able to successfully receive a signal. If you didn't get a signal, click the left button, change your frequency up to 390 megahertz, and click back. And then press a button on your Genie remote. See if you can receive it at 390 megahertz. My remote sends on both 315 and 390. I'm going to go ahead and click back to exit out of the application. And then I'll say exit and then back again. And now this time I'll choose apps. And then I'll go down to sub gigahertz and choose Genie door recorder. If you have a 390 megahertz remote, you're going to go to application user, Genie recorder, genie.c, and then change the frequency from 315 to 390 megahertz. Make sure QFlipper is not running, then do Control Shift B, and then choose debug launch app on Flipper. That should build fairly quickly, and then it'll launch the Genie recorder application. This is my three-button Genie remote. I've taken that left pin, stuck a wire through it, and it comes down and around. You can see this trace, and it goes to the left side of each of these two button pads. And then that third wire goes to ground, and it's basically all this big material here is connected to that third wire. You can see it on the very top here connecting. When I tap the wires together, you'll see the light turn on. There it goes on the remote. So that means it's working. The wire with the black tape is the one that goes to ground. So I'll put that into the GND pin on the Flipper Zero. And then if you're really confident, you can take the battery out. You need to make sure that you know which one is ground if you're doing this. And then you can connect an alligator clip to the positive of the battery terminal. Just make sure it doesn't reach in and accidentally touch the negative. You don't want to short that out for sure. Make sure it's only touching the positive. And then we can put that into 3.3 volt, the 3V3 pin on the Flipper Zero. So now to test that that's working, I'm just going to go ahead and connect the other wire to ground temporarily. And we can see that the light turned on my remote. So let me do that one more time to show you. The light just turned on. Great. So now we're ready to put that into pin A7. And that way the Flipper can control the wire. We'll click on start and the Flipper will start clicking buttons on the remote. And then it's receiving that key lock code and 64-bit codes. And you can see that the remote just keeps blinking. We need to let this run for 65,536 or higher. After that, it should loop around. It is possible that some remotes may quit working after 65,000 codes, so do this at your own risk. Once you have 66,000 codes, go ahead and hit that back button to stop the application and then back again. You can resume the app and it'll start where it left off. We're going to go into SD card and then apps data and then Genie, and there's a keys.txt. Go ahead and right click on that and say download. And then choose a location to save the file. The file will have an incrementing counter starting at 1, and then it'll have all of the keys that it's recorded. I've copied my keys file into Flipper Zero tutorials, sub gigahertz, samples, Genie, GIRUD-1T, keys.txt. Earlier in the video, we captured a remote for that 315 megahertz, and then we did one at the 390 megahertz. Those were our codes at the time. When we look in our keys file, we can see on line 1065 and 1066 those entries. And so this means the next signal that the remote was going to send would be this BFE528D. So I'm going to copy that onto the clipboard. Then I'll open that genie.py file, and where it says numbers, I'll replace that with the value on my clipboard, which is the next code we want to send. Then we'll right click on genie.py and choose open an integrated terminal. And then we'll type Python space genie.py. And that will generate a genie.sub file for us. I'll right click on the genie.sub file and choose Reveal in File Explorer. Next, I'll bring up QFlipper, go to SD card, and then sub gigahertz. And then I will drag the genie.sub file into my Flipper. The final step, we'll go into sub gigahertz, and then we'll go down to saved. And then we'll go to our Genie file that we just copied over, and we'll click the OK button, and the garage door should open. Don't forget to revert your firmware so you can decode keylock files. One last thing I forgot to point out is in your Genie.py file, you should change the frequency to 390 megahertz if you're transmitting and receiving on 390 instead of 315. Please like and subscribe. In a future video, we'll look at some of the more technical details around the Genie and the ability to make a small set of subfiles that will always open the door.